Matt, you specifically asked me to talk Derby to you today on Horse Center, but I want to talk a little bit about the fillies, the Kentucky Oaks. Gotta love the fillies too, and the Derby's huge, but the Kentucky Oaks is a very big, important race in its own right. Last year, Abel Tasman came from way back to win the Oaks. She was the three-year-old filly champion. That's happened a lot over the years. I think it could happen again this year. And Matt, we're looking at a bit of a showdown here with the Kentucky Derby deep on the top end of the pool with a lot of good horses. The Kentucky Oaks, there's two fillies who have really announced themselves as the top three-year-old fillies in the country. Of course, I'm talking about Monomoy Girl and Midnight Bisou. We were at the Ashland to see Monomoy Girl last time.
We sure were, Brian, and it was no contest in that race. Monomoy Girl put on a real show and took that field easily, leading the race most of the way around the track, which was very interesting because in her previous win at the fairgrounds in the Rachel Alexandra, she ran a completely different kind of race, rallying from the back of the field. It was a small field, but rallying from the back of the field in there, which shows the talent of that horse, that she can win from the front end or she can win rallying.
Absolutely. Monomoy Girl has been good from the beginning, Matt, whether it was Indiana Downs or right here at Churchill Downs last fall. Her only loss was a tough one indeed. She's absolutely done nothing wrong for trainer Brad Cox, one of the top young trainers in the country, daughter of Tapizar, which makes me worry just a little bit about 9 furlongs if she's pressured too much early, but certainly a big talent, the Chestnut Filly. Ashland, She got a hold of an easy pace, and to her credit, she just blitzed them. She did what she was supposed to do with the pace advantage. And in the race, Rachel Alexandra, of course, she didn't get out of the gate very well, so that's why she came from way back. So obviously showing her quality, a filly of high quality. She deserves to be favorite in the Kentucky Oaks, Matt, but all year long, my top Oaks filly has been another one. She's the one coming from the West Coast, a daughter of Midnight Loot for trainer Bill Spar. I'm talking about, of course, the Santa Anita Oaks winner, Midnight Bisou.
And Brian, you have been touting Midnight Bisou since the beginning of the year, and she has done nothing but make you look good in there. She's 3 for 3 this year, has run really nicely. She's a late rallier, which I think is a good thing in this Kentucky Oaks field. The Oaks is a really interesting race, and folks, I'm looking forward to the 2-day daily double with the Kentucky Oaks and the Kentucky Derby, which is a great wager to think about because, again, you get to hook these Oaks horses up with horses from that 20-horse field of the Derby, and that gets you good value.
Yeah, Matt, and I'll be throwing in a little bit on one of my favorite bets of the year with the big turf race as well on Saturday in that Oaks Derby and turf pick 3. Getting back to Midnight Bisou, Matt, she's been able to stay close to the pace and make her explosive move. But in the Santa Anita Oaks, she was able to show what she can do with a little bit more pace up front. She came from way back, and the move was pretty darn electrifying. I've said before, I'll say it again, she really does remind me of Blind Luck a lot in her running style. I like Midnight Bisou to upset. It's going to be a mild upset because she's a heavy, heavy second choice in here. But I like her just a bit to upset the apple cart, beat Monomoy Girl. But we are talking about two very good three-year-old fillies in the Kentucky Oaks.
Yep, we certainly are. And it's going to be a field of 14 going 9 furlongs.
Going 9 furlongs. There isn't as much pace as we thought there might be. The fantasy pace setter, the filly from Minnesota, will not be in here. So Monomoy Girl might not have the fastest of paces to worry about, but with fillies like Take George Paula, Classy Act, there should be a strong pace, or at least a reasonable pace in the Oaks for it to be a fair race. Speaking of fair races, I think Eskimo Kisses, we looked at the Ashland a little bit. She really didn't have a fair race because that was easy for Monomoy Girl on the lead from the rail with a slow pace. She made up a lot of ground for trainer Kenny McPeak, and I think Eskimo Kisses, if she gets a better setup in the Oaks, is an interesting horse to run a big race as well.
Yeah, she did make up a lot of ground. And like you said, Brian, there wasn't much pace. And hey, she wasn't going to catch Monomoy Girl under those kind of circumstances. But she made a really nice run for Kenny McBeak. And he's the kind of trainer that can get a horse ready for a big performance in a big race.
Matt, I think the third choice in the Oaks is an interesting one. She's been working in California for her new trainer, Bob Baffert. She's never run anywhere but Maidan. She won the UAE Oaks, was her biggest win, and then she ran second, albeit it was a long way second to Mendelssohn. But Raya is an interesting filly coming out of that mile 3/16th race against the boys where she was able to beat everyone else. She was second. Now with Bob Baffert, he's had a little bit of time with her to get her ready. She's got to be a little bit of an X factor in this Kentucky Oaks.
She certainly does. And she came back after winning the Oaks at Dubai and came back on a little bit of short rest and, hey, beat an entire field of boys except for Mendelssohn. And the plan all along was for this horse after the UAE Derby to come to the United States and go into the barn of Bob Baffert. So there was a plan with this horse all along. And hey, nobody's better at getting horses ready for big races than Mr. Baffert.
I'm going to try to see if she can beat me as the third choice in here, though, Matt. I like a few other long shots better. Eskimo Kisses as for one. Coach Rocks is really coming to hand lately for trainer Dale Romans. Finally, after a few attempts, she finally broke her maiden in big style down in South Florida, and then she came right back to win the Gulfstream Park Oaks. Coach Rocks certainly deserves consideration in here, as do the Fantasy 1-2, Matt. I don't know if you saw the Fantasy Live, but it was a heck of a race. These two fillies, Wonder Godot and Sassy Sienna, put away that speed filly late, and they ding-donged it down the stretch in the Fantasy. I thought Sassy Sienna, who's also from the Brad Cox barn of Monomoy Girl, got the best of Wonder Godot after it looked like Wonder Godot might have the jump on her.
Yeah, certainly did. Sassy Sienna got the win. Wonder Godot has been right there in four tries on the road to the Kentucky Oaks, but she's come up a little short with a couple seconds and a couple thirds. So out of that duo, I think I like Sassy Sienna a little bit better.
Yeah, and Wonder Godot, of course, was the Canadian Tyrrell Filly champion and the Demoiselle winner last fall, so we know she likes nine furlongs. Other horses we haven't even mentioned yet. Blamed is the Toast of New Mexico. Unfortunately, she's never run away. The Kentucky bred has never run away from New Mexico racing, so we really don't know too much about her class level. She's going to get a big test here, but she's looked good in New Mexico. My Miss Lily looked like a filly who might pop up, and she certainly did, winning the Gazelle last time in a hard-fought victory for Mark Hennig. So another couple who should be interesting options in the Oaks.
Yep, the filly from New Mexico lost her first race in her maiden start, but then has strung together five wins in a row. And My Miss Lily looked really good at Aqueduct, but that wasn't the strongest field in that race.
The consistent Take Charge Paula should add speed, as should Classy Act, who disappointed just a little bit in the Fairgrounds Oaks. They should make a little bit interesting pace scenario there for Monomoy Girl early. Chocolate Martini's come from nowhere to win two in a row. I don't know if she can upset another one in here. Red Ruby disappointed last time at Oakland, but I think she's got some talent. And finally, Patrona Margarita is looking for another big upset. She got one last fall at Churchill Downs.
Yeah, so it's an interesting field, but I don't know, Brian. It seems to me like it's pretty likely that the winner is going to come from the top two that we mentioned, Monomoy Girl and Midnight Bisou.
Well, if Eskimo Kisses can somehow turn the table on Monomoy Girl, I wouldn't mind a Midnight Bisou over Eskimo Kisses exacta. But for my money, yeah, it looks more likely that the top two, Midnight Bisou on top for me, Monomoy Girl second in the Kentucky Oaks.